Welcome back and hello if you are new. So, following from the brutish release that was Blood Mountain, Mastodon would enter into the studio to record their fourth album. However, changing things up, the modus operandi of this record was, instead of being as aggressive as possible, to really kind of take a step back and understand how to use and play with the idea of space. With members of the band listening to King Crimson's In the Court of the Crimson King and Pink Floyd's Animals on a daily basis, it would prove to be the perfect diet to create one of the best progressive metal masterpieces of the last 10 years. This week, we astral travel 10 years back to celebrate the anniversary of Mastodon's Crack the Sky. Ranging from the lengthy track times to the sophisticated songwriting, Crack the Sky really was the definition of being out there. And particularly when it comes to the album's story. As you know, concepts are a huge part of a Mastodon record. It discusses the story of a man who is disabled and can only travel when he astral travels. So, following one of his travels, he strays slightly too close to the sun, similar to Icarus, and burns off the sort of umbilical cord, if you will, on his solar plexus, meaning that he's floating around and he gets sucked into a wormhole into the spirit realm. Standard Mastodon, really. In this wormhole, he meets all of these other spirits and they believe that he's actually dead. However, they perform a divination, realize that he's not, and try and get him back to his actual world. The spirits end up sending him into the body of Rasputin, who then dies, where Rasputin's soul and his soul kind of go out into the ether together, and they have this massive long journey to try and get back home. Musically, the record is just as challenging as the album's story, with many different twists and turns. The second track, Quintessence, is an absolutely perfect encapsulation of this kind of ethereal idea that the band put together for this record. As you may all know, that up until this record, every album that Mastodon would release had to do with a certain element, and Crack the Sky was the idea of the element of the ether, basically. Nevertheless, the band were also inspired by the progressive titans of the likes of Emerson, Lake and Palmer, which we can hear on the use of those really haunting organ sounds before we're once again whisked off into another gust of clean guitar that creates this sort of mantra-like kaleidoscopic feel. Nevertheless, despite this progressive aspect of the album, it shows that Mastodon's claws have certainly not dulled, and there are some absolutely ridiculously heavy riffs on this album. For example, the impervious riffs that appear on The Ghost of Caralea. Or following that, The Gallop of the Tsar. But for me, none of them match the 1-2 punch of Scott Kelly's guest vocals on the title track, Crack the Sky. And perhaps one of the most noteworthy aspects of Crack the Sky was the arrival of multiple different vocalists for the band. A good example is the introduction of Oblivion. Initially, the track is led by Brand's voice in the main verse. I feel beyond the sun before it was time. However, then Troy's Herculean bellows come through as we're moving into the pre-chorus. And then the wheel is given over to Brent, who kind of handles that higher register chorus. And all of these vocal styles would prove to be yet another masterful string to Mastodon's ever-expanding bow. Although Crack the Sky may well be a journey into the cosmos, for me there's always been this inherent nature of sadness, of melancholia, and the album was dedicated to Brand's sister, who sadly passed away at the very young age of 14, who was called Sky. And it's been, he's been quoted in various different documentaries mentioning that, you know, that moment that he found out that she had passed felt as though the sky could have cracked. For me, this sadness has never been more apparent than the final track of The Last Baron. Crack the Sky is the perfect amalgamation of 70s prog rock ideas with a modern metal twist. Able to achieve an ethereal sound and able to expand the band's overall repertoire whilst remaining quintessentially true to the sound that Mastodon have adopted, it's a testament to their fearless songwriting ability. And 10 years later, this progressive odyssey still towers over any competition put towards it. So, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, hit that like and subscribe button. Make sure to subscribe to my channel, The Metal Trist, as well. I've got interviews, album reviews, all sorts of interesting stuff for you. We've got plenty of apocalyptic anniversaries in the bank, and loads more on the way. Drop a comment, let me know what you think. Was Crack the Sky your Mastodon moment? I'd love to know. And I'll see you guys next week for another apocalyptic anniversaries. All right, take care, guys.